When you look back at your time on the main roster, your first run of your career, what are some of your favorite moments or memories?
First would be Mickie James and I had a match in England, and I think I was champ for almost a year, better part of the year. And then finally I had a match overseas with Mickie, and Mickie beat me in a big surprise. Like, I think it was like maybe the first non-US title change in a long time. Certainly, I think, for the women's title. And anyways, that match was so special to me because I had never been a part of a crowd reaction like that. Like, I get goosebumps even thinking about it. I saw, like, in my peripheral, all the people stand up and, like, Mickie's reaction. It was, like, probably the most real moment I had felt in wrestling up until that point. So I always remember that. That was really special. I remember all the stuff I did with Santino. There's too many to name.
Right. I had that note in my notes here, and I was like, oh man, that we need an episode unto itself for that whole period.
Yeah, you need to have him on. He also, a lot of that was off the cuff. A lot of that, he would work his damnedest to get me to crack because I was pretty good at having the serious face. And so he made it his goal often to go off the cuff and say things under his breath that would just kill me. So that was real special. And then, of course, being in the men's Royal Rumble, I think, is probably my career defining. Like, if there was one thing that put me in a category deserving of Hall of Fame, which I still wonder how the hell I even got there. but me looking up to China as a role model and a true trailblazer, somebody that was like the first to knock the door down and deal with a lot of
right,
and really be a representation of something so different and diverse amongst the women. My mind was blown when I saw her. I was like, this woman, she's the one that was inspired me to lift weights and just, you know, I was like, wow, you can be powerful and beautiful and there is equality in the future. And so being able to walk in her footsteps 10 years later was the most special thing in the universe. Like, it's still, I still have, like, I almost blacked out during that whole moment because it was just so big and life-changing for me.
Like what you hear? Catch full episodes of After the Bell on Spotify. Follow us now and never miss an episode.